I am really excited today because I've heard that our treasure island that I restocked in the last episode has been mega popular. I've seen things in chat, I've seen people talk about it, and I haven't checked it out. I purposely not been close to the shopping district. Where is it? Why do I always think that it's... Oh my goodness, look at this! That is looking absolutely fantastic! My goodness, this brings back vibes to Season 6 and the build-off, Scar's build. I'm guessing that this is a Scar build. This looks unbelievable. Look at this place! I have to find out what it sells now. It seems to be dirt, coarse dirt, grass blocks, more dirt, podsol. It sells podsol. Leaves? It sells leaves? Oh my goodness, this place sells leaves! Okay, now that is a very pleasant surprise. Does it sell every single leaf? That's oak leaves. What is this? Jungle leaves. Okay, it sells both types of leaves. I may need to do a little bit of shopping here. There are no prizes though. I don't know if this place is open yet, but it looks omega. It looks absolutely omega. While we're here, we should also check this. What? We've almost sold out. We've got a crafting table. I can't believe this. This is the one thing that I've really, really wanted. I gotta be honest, I haven't seen this before, and it's not looking as good as I was hoping. What is up with that black border around it? Anyway, that is one of the things that I really wanted. And sea lantern glowstone. Ooh. Yep. We got quartz in here. We got so many cool ones. Okay, I think it may be time today to empty this and see what we can install in our storage system. This is an iron block. That's looking cool. I keep getting distracted. Now, for the big reveal, I have made a lot of... It's sold out! It's genuinely sold out! Every single box is gone! Stonks! I can't believe this! I cannot believe this! How many diamonds have I made here? I did reinvest 17 diamond blocks, but we've definitely made a profit here. No, actually, thinking about it, I reinvested 21 diamond blocks. We have made 38 diamond blocks. That's a profit of 17 diamond blocks. Unbelievable. It sold out in one episode time. Okay, people really like this new way of doing it, where there's always something in the boxes, I guess. Now, with the success of this, we obviously have to capitalize on it. We obviously have to capitalize on it and stock it once again. But I think it's one of those things that you should leave be for maybe a few episodes. Make them want it. Yeah, make them miss the idea of harvesting gems. Anyway, I'm gonna take my profit and we're gonna head back to the base. Cyclops showing purple. I don't really know if I would want to press yellow if it's ever in yellow. I know that the game has a higher value for yellow, orange, and red than green, but it's gonna look weird. It's gonna look really, really weird. What in the world is that? Alan? Is this your making? There's bird poop flying about my base. Is that a bird holding this thing up? Pesky bird. What in the world is this? Welcome to the HMS Pesky Bird, flying in to give you a great deal. Today's offer is the entire barge for just 60 diamonds. You get all of it, minus the pesky bird. 311 stacks of leaves. What? You're joking me. What in the world? 311 stacks of leaves. Hello, bird. I like how he's looking at me, judging my decision making here. What does this mean though? You get the entire barge? I guess that means that I get the materials that it's built out of, the leaves, the chest, etc. And I have to buy the diorite. Is that how this works? I have to buy. I have to. Ugh. What? No, come on now. Just doing some math here. 60 split in 311. It's 0.19. So I'm paying one diamond for 5 stacks of leaves. That is an incredibly good price, is it not? The only problem is I don't want to buy your poop. I think the way this works, first of all, I'm pretty sure this is a Grian thing, right? Because it looks exactly like his barge in the... it says pesky bird, okay? It says pesky bird. I'm pretty sure the whole idea is that I need to buy the diorite. Now, that is something I don't think I've ever done. Paid for diorite. Oh, but all the leaves, though... I genuinely don't know what to do about this. You pesky bird, you sitting up on your throne. You have made me have to make a really difficult decision. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 through 60. 0.06. So I am paying 0.06 diamonds per diorite block. You truly are a pesky bird. I'm gonna have to think about this. I'm gonna have to give this a little bit of thought, okay? I really want the leaves. I think the leaves are priced at a great price. But I'm gonna have to give it some thought. Some decisions are really hard to make. Others, not that hard. And one of those easy decisions to make happened right when I was done with my last episode. In fact, while I was editing my last episode, Mumbo Jumbo was building something next to the Treasure Island. And so later that evening, I went there just to check it out. And what I found was unbelievable. I have completely run out of diamonds. What is this? And desperate times lead to desperate measures. So I built this store by Mumbo's Bits. For goodness sake. The biggest skill tripping thing I've ever seen. Right, so what is this? Buy my mustache. 64 diamonds. Has he gone mad? He's literally selling his bits. I would be a fool if I didn't buy this. Oh, it's gone. Buy my mustache and wear it on your skin. I will then be stashless. That replaces my missing stash. How did I miss this? Buy my hair and buy my suit. Oh, the suit is still here. Buy my suit and wear it on your skin. Then I will be suitless, or you can make me a new suit that replaces my missing suit. Okay, so that's still here. And the hair has also been sold. Of course it has. So this is 16 diamonds. Okay, I gotta be honest, this is a sign. I had 17 diamonds inside my ender chest. That is, if that's not a sign, then I don't know what is. Message me if you bought a token and I will send you my bits. I don't know why that's so funny. I didn't actually message him yet because being me, I obviously keep a Mumbo suit in my wardrobe. So let's take these clothes off and change into his suit. Wow, I've never tried this on before, but I think it suits me. The suit suits me. I'm not gonna lie, it feels a little bit weird from this angle though. I'm not used to wearing this type of fancy clothes. Now this also gave me the opportunity to design a new suit for Mumbo, an opportunity I've obviously taken. Genuinely can't wait. I can't wait for you all to see the suit that I've designed. I can't wait for him to see the suit that I've designed for him. That being said though, we do need a little bit of a changing room for him, okay? We're gonna get him over here. We're gonna get him into a little bit of a changing room. The changing room of doom. Mumbo, can you come to my base? Can I? Hello? Look at this, am I in trouble? No, well, made a purchase. Yes, he's on his way, good. Oh my goodness.
I'd forgotten about the fact that, so I know you said that you'd made a purchase, right?
Yes.
I still, in my head, kind of didn't really prepare myself mentally for you wearing my suit.
I gotta say, it is very fitting, isn't it?
It does actually really suit you. Yeah. You look better than I ever did in it, which is quite upsetting.
Your suit really suits me. Pun.
That's, kind of.
Can you take off your hat for me?
Sure. Why? Oh, I. You know what? I'd forgotten that I was naked as well. So
yeah, it's it. Is. Look at the top of your head, dude.
What's happened? I can't look at the top of my head. I can't just see.
Open
it.
Your.
What's happened, dude? What's happened? Did I? Oh no, I'm not very good at doing skins. I'm not very good at doing skins, dude. What's happened?
You got a naked head.
I forgot to. I forgot to.
That is funny.
How does that even happen?
Oh, that is so funny.
How does that even happen?
I have bought your suit. Check it out. Oh, that's your suit token. And yeah, I cannot stand looking at that any longer. So if you would do me the honor of just step in here, we're gonna change you up. I've got you a
this
new
doesn't
suit.
Sound good. The changing room of dude. You have anything, to kind of work on your.
Anything is better than what you're wearing now, dude.
Okay, yeah, true. Yes. True.
Good. We go in there and we do and no, still didn't work.
No, has it not worked?
No.
I mean, I don't think you made the noise quite right. You need to.
Did it work this time? Yes.
Does it work? Has it? Okay. How do I look?
Take your trousers off. Take your trousers off. Take your shoes off.
Oh no! Oh no! Oh what? What have you done to me, dude?
That is brilliant.
What have you done to me? My arms are out, which is a bit. This is a strange.
Yes.
You've given
yes.
me my suit. Well, you've left the top half of my suit.
Since
my,
you like. Since you like wearing the belt up at your chest, I figured that you'd want old man pants.
You give me old man pants.
I missed doing the sides. I'm not a great tailor. I'll have to fix that.
So, wait, hang on. These are like dungarees. You've given me dungarees, basically, dude. Is there any particular reason why you left my arms out? I mean, I know I've got lovely arms. There's no denying that. But is there?
You look
is
like
there any
Popeye.
Reason?
You look like Popeye a little bit. No, I don't know. It looked weird having, it's like a short-sleeved blazer jacket.
Yeah, that's, do they exist? Have you created a new fashion thing
in two years'
time everyone's going to be rocking? With this, I like the little white collars. I like the little, I still have cuffs, but they're up my arms, which is really funny.
We kept laughing for an additional 10 minutes at that point in time.
Dude, by the way, I'm absolutely loving the way that this area is looking. I look over from my base to see your tree trunk and just see your branches expanding and things like that. It's looking completely crazy.
Thank you, and I will apologize for it. It takes quite a long time to do the branches, but we're up to two now. I'm sorry. I can't get over the fact that your head is completely bald.
Stop
on top.
It. Stop mentioning it. I can't even see it.
You're walking around like this, bro. Like...
It's true. It's impossible not to mention. All right, but anyway. That's what you get. You have to observe my bald head, all right?
Yes.
Because
yep.
You've built a base that is so incredibly vertical, so obviously I have to look directly straight upwards.
Looks hilarious.
What are you actually planning on building in this area here? Are you gonna have like farms going through the center of it, or is there gonna be farms in the branches, or is there gonna be farms around the tree?
For goodness sake, I'm sure I'm gonna have some mini farms, but I'm trying to be lag optimized this season.
Right.
So I'm gonna take a leaf out of your book. I think it was very clever what you did last season with an industrial district sort of thing, and you've already got that villager area. So I'm gonna do that industrial district style.
So you're going to build an I've kind of been thinking about building an industrial district myself as well, because there's no denying it, they're like the most fun projects. That's like a dream project for me. It's just a huge space that you have available for just building stupid stuff and technical stuff.
We can both do it.
What, have like competing industrial districts just gradually? I mean, you know how this
goes,
right?
I was originally thinking, well, we can help each other out, but...
No, I
see.
Like, it's fine.
I see how it is.
What if we gave ourselves like parameters and we both worked within those parameters? So say, for example, we gave ourselves like a 50 by 50 area or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And we try and build industrial districts that are not better than one another, not necessarily competing. It's more like a curiosity thing. Like, what does Iskall do with the same amount of space as Mumbo's got in terms of
making
something
industrial. I like where this is going. And I also really like how you managed to turn everything into sort of a... hold on. How you managed to turn everything into sort of like a... Hermit challenges initiation.
That was a great little, yeah, that was a good entrance.
50 by 50. I was gonna go bigger though. I was thinking at least 100 by 100.
Would 100 by 100?
Yeah, I want to do a kind of a mega one.
So we're actually going all out. We're going
Omega. Oh. I can't look at the top of your head, bro. I'm sorry.
Okay, I'll look up. I'll address you like this from this point forth. Okay, this is better. Okay, good. Good stuff. Yeah. Good stuff. This feels like a totally natural conversation now. All right. So how about this? What if, because it would be nice if we could both see each other's industrial districts. So you want to go 50, but you want to go 100 by 100. What if I say we go 128 by 128, fill up a map. We both have maps in our bases. I can check out what you're doing. You can check out what I'm doing. We can admire each other from afar, and we can both have awesome industrial districts. And it's not a competition. It's just a curiosity thing. But my industrial district might end up being slightly better than yours.
Or not.
How does that sound?
Is this where you fly off and just continue talking?
Because I was expecting
that you would just continue to talk with this 12 bamboo voice and just fly off. I got so used to it that I started looking up as you were talking.
All right, the time is now. Thanks. I like this idea.
Sounds good. Sounds good. Right, yes. Cool. Okay. Right. Bye.
See you later.
I am really excited about this competition. Parallel industrial district making. This is going to be really fun, and it's exactly what I had planned to do next, an industrial Omega base. And I really like the idea of making this 128 by 128 so that it will fit one map. So I have prepared some stuff. I prepared the map, and I still need a little bit more obsidian. But the idea is that we'll find an area out somewhere in the distance, and then we'll set up shop and make sure that everything fits into one map. I was really hoping that there was going to be obsidian down here in my mine, but is that obsidian? That's obsidian. Okay, thank goodness. 10. That's all we need. So I think what I'm going to do is just fly off in this general direction, west. I'm going to fly west of my base quite far and try and find an area that seems suitable for an industrial district. And I'm not really too fussed about the terrain. I just want an area that's kind of flat. And one thing I just thought of is that if I would do it in an ice biome, then I could make myself an ice farm. The only thing is I gotta make sure that there's nothing over here, and I'm not sure if this is the jungle that Etho lives in. We do not want... Ooh, jungle temple. As I was saying, we do not want an area that is loaded when other players are around. It needs to be an AFK area. Is this not even looted? Are you kidding me? This is not looted. This is a good sign. There's bamboo in the treasure chest. I approve of that. I gotta be honest, I've never known how to correctly open the last treasure room. Unless this is the correct way of opening it. Just break through, and that's how you get in here. Ah, there we go. More gold. I'm definitely not placing my industrial area in another jungle though, but I think that area over there may actually be perfect for this. Oh, wait a minute. It is very, very close to Mumbo Jumbo's villager district. Does that matter though? Is that going to be out of the loaded area? If I'm all the way over here, I think that would be out of the loading distance. Or if I'd build it around this general area. As long as I can get a little bit of this snow tundra. Oh, wait a minute. Yes, yes, yes. This is my first wandering trader since starting to collect microblocks. What do you have? Endstone we already have. Coal we don't have. We have these two. We have the dispenser. I think we have purple. Ah, this is a pretty bad one. That is so funny. I have been looking out for you for so long and you haven't appeared. I guess having a big flat area as my industrial district may very well be very useful for getting wandering traders as well. Ooh, ice spikes. I may have found a really good area, and it would be this little area over here, alternatively this area here, where this spike or part, nook of the ice spike biome kind of enters into the plains biome. I think I want to give this a try. And what I mean by saying give this a try is because we're doing this in a map, I can't fully decide. I can't really fully myself decide. I just have to open the map and hope that the borders of the map sort of fits good with my plan. So, let's do that now. And that's terrible. No. Okay, that means that we missed the entire ice biome. If we'd be in this grid and open another map, we'd get quite a bit of the ice biome in there. Maybe too much. So, let's make another map and then open this one here. Yeah, it's not half of the district that would be the ice spike. You know what? That may not be terrible. Now, I do also plan to have some sort of mob farm in my industrial district, so I would have to do a lot of cave lighting and stuff. This is an Omega project, by the way. Did I say that? This is an Omega project, regardless of where we do it. Do one more map test over here, and then I'm actually out of paper. But this definitely has less of that ice biome, but still probably enough to make a decent ice farm, I would think. Maybe this is better. That being said, this one contains some forest that I'd have to clean out. So what do you say, Sonny? Yeah, okay. He just said yes. That's it. this is going to be the area. This is going to be the industrial district. And I've got a bit of clearing of land to do. And I also was thinking that I want to border this out. And I wonder if there's going to be enough stone to make a border. I hope so. I'm not going to lie. I have been really, really eager to start. And I've been really excited about starting more of the technical parts of my Season 7 journey. And I have given this a lot of thought over the past few weeks of how to start it and where to start it and stuff like that. And an industrial district is just such a great idea. It's such a great idea because of the fact that it's very, very lag friendly. And that is the reason for why I've chosen to build this far out in the distance where no one else is loading it, so that I can AFK at my farms or be at my farms whenever I need to farm things, but they are not constantly running and they're not interrupting with my main base and stuff. And it also gives me a lot of cool opportunities. I've already got a lot of ideas for what I want to do storage system wise and transporting of items and things like that. I'm actually really, really excited to get this going. We're gonna have an ice farm because I chose this area. I think I also want to do a squid farm, but we're also gonna have all of the standard things, cactus, bamboo, and all of those sort of things. It's gonna be one of those Omega projects. It's gonna be really, really fun. I'm starting to realize just how big this area is. Right, next I also need to link up a nether portal. According to my calculations, this is the area for the nether portal. I'm a bit worried that portal is this close. I don't, that's not Ethos Ice Farm, by the way. I don't know what that is. Pretty sure this is gonna mislink though. Wait a minute. Yes, it actually created a new portal. Nice. I gotta say, I'm Omega excited about this industrial district. I think it's gonna be absolutely great. Now, it is gonna be very technical, okay? It's gonna have a lot of farms, but in addition to a lot of farms, I also wanna try and make it look good. So, I think as far as block palette goes, I do want to try and go really, really factory, old school factory style. So using these blocks here, some regular andesite, and some stone and cobblestone. I'm actually going to be building with granite. And I think this is going to be really fun. This is going to be a really, really fun project. I'm going to try and keep to this sort of old school style. Maybe some dark gray concrete and concrete powder for like asphalt and stuff like that. And even though I didn't clear out that much land yet, I did actually manage to get myself quite a bit of resources, namely leaves and some packed ice, which is absolutely great. But speaking about leaves, I've had a thought all day about the pesky bird, and I think I made a decision. So let's head back to the Omega tree. Now here's the thing, I really don't like having to pay for diorite, but 311 delivered delivered leaves, oak leaves, is going to mean at least one more branch of leaves. And it's delivered right here by a pesky bird. Is that more dire? I swear this is more dire right now. Yeah, there was... Oh no! Pesky bird, what are you doing? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's an... Oh. I think I know what that means. I definitely have to buy this and get rid of this as quick as I can before the pesky bird does more damage than good. I didn't actually check, but has the price gone up as well with more weight? With more weight on the barge, has the price gone up? No, it's still 60 diamonds. Good. You should always tip delivery. So I think what we'll do is 60 diamonds is a little bit less than 7 blocks of diamonds, but I'm going to give 7 blocks of diamonds for the pesky bird, and hopefully that means no more pooping. Ah, this is absolutely brilliant. What's not as brilliant though is having paid for these 9 blocks of diorite. That being said, I'm not going to burn them straight away. These requires a special destruction treatment of doom. Questionable pesky investment. If you got any destructive suggestions, please feel free to let me know down below in the comments. I got a lot of leaves to collect from the pesky bird's barge, but with that being said, we are unfortunately out of video time for today. Now, I'm extremely excited about... Oh, I can't... That's stupid. There, that's better. I'm extremely excited about the industrial district, and I think next time we'll probably start building some of the farms, or at least get the foundation of the Omega industrial district all nailed down. So with that said, I really do hope that you have enjoyed today's episode. If you did, do hit the like button down below, and if you're brand new, consider subscribing, and I will see you dudes in the next episode.